It's just commercial ice.
Steve didn't introduce me, so allow me to introduce me. I'm Jeff, and I own Mystic Ice Cream about an hour from here. And I decided that since this is the first class of the year, rather than just make flavors, I thought we would teach a little bit. So that's what I'm going to do. If you have any questions, of course, ask along the way, because this will be more than just showing you how to make an ice cream. This will be a little learning. I do have a book here that details this, and I do teach a course where we go into it in greater depth. But for today, this will be perfect. You'll gain a real understanding of how we do it. As Steve told you, I'm new school, but old school. I came into this business. I sat back where that pretty girl was sitting 7 years ago. And knowing nothing about ice cream, but I was going to retire and I wanted something else, much like most of the people who come to my class. They're retired, they want to retire, they want to build a future for their kids or whatever, or just to become financially independent, which is ridiculously easy in the frozen dessert business. So I learned how to make, well, I didn't learn how to make ice cream sitting there. What I learned was that it could be done, and because of my intense love for ice cream, I could do it. So after sitting there, I bought a machine, a six-quart machine. And being totally new and not knowing anything, my thought was not to buy jars and cans of colors and flavors, but rather what I simply did the day it was hooked up in my kitchen in the house. I went to the supermarket, and I took a cart, and I walked up and down all the aisles looking at anything that I thought would make good ice cream. And, of course, I took Oreos, and I took cans of coconut, and I took cookies, and all the candies certainly looked good. And I came home and started experimenting, and I made some pretty good ice cream out of foods that we've grown up with and that we know the taste of. As much as the cans try to replicate the taste that we grew up with of, let's say, Oreos or coconut or anything, I like the foods. So I have built a following through my class of hundreds of people who now go supermarketing rather than go online buying cans and stuff. And as you can see, it's go supermarketing. Make incredible ice cream without buying jugs, cans, or jars of flavors or colors. And that's what I believe in, and I still do it. And now I do it even on more expanded basis. So, in my store, I always thought it would be great to sell ice cream that's candy. Everybody likes all these things. I certainly do. And there's here I just have a small sample, Twix, Hershey's with almonds, Snickers, Payday, M&M's, Kit Kat, and Nestle Crunch. There's also Reese's Peanut Butter Cups, and there anything you see, we can make ice cream out of. And it's a very simple technique. Any of these, any candy bar in the world that you see, you can make ice cream out of. Any cake, any cookie, pretty much anything, right? You can make ice cream out of using this technique. So, today, this is the number one candy bar in the world, by the way, Snickers. So I thought, being interested in making some money, why not have Snickers ice cream? So, here's how to do it. And here's how to do it out of any candy bar. It's a three-step process, very simple. It only requires you buying one thing, and that's this. Traditional blenders with the three blades on the bottom, even a Vitamix, no good. They're not going to do it. Yes, I bought a Vitamix for $500 and sold it because they don't work. The reason they don't work is because no matter how strong it is, there's just a blade on the bottom. That's it. Ninja came along several years ago, and they created this, which is six blades, extremely sharp. And yesterday I unpacked a new one to bring here, and right away sliced my finger open. But this is the reason that you can do this out of any foods you want. This one piece of equipment right here. These Ninjas run less than $100, and they last literally forever. They don't break. And you never have to sharpen it. They're almost self-sharpening because of the design of it. The whole thing is just like a blender, a base motor, a, come on, container. This, and a cover. So the way to do this is to take any candy bar. Let's say we're going to do Snickers. We'll do a few today, but we'll start with Snickers. It's a phenomenal seller in the store because when you taste it, what you're going to taste is this, because that's all we're making it out of, this. So how would you do that? You can't put these in the Ninja or any blender. You'd get a lot of gummy and the motor would burn out. So, well, yes, you do freeze them, but you can't then take these little blocks of rocks and put them in here. So what I do is I had you do it yesterday, right? I take them on a cutting board after you determine how many you need, which is another part of the class, and I slice them and then put them in a container and then freeze them. And what we get is this. This is what happens overnight. And because of I had to go through a process to see how to cut them, I decided that this way is better because now they break easily. So we're making a half batch. I at my store, I have a 24 quart. Steve's got me on a 12 quart today, so I brought enough to make a half, what I call a half a batch. And as I tell you every month here, put your recipes on these cards, put them in a file box, and that way you know where they are and they don't get lost and all that. So we're going to, this is 24 of these, 24 Snickers bars. Is this recipe in the book? It is in the book, isn't it? Yeah. And all we're going to do is throw them in here now, and I'm breaking them as I'm doing it, and they break real good now. Originally, I was cutting them into chunks.
So you're using 24 for 12 quarts.
Correct.
Still break them up.
Yeah, I break them up because it's less burden on the motor. I'm sure this motor could handle it either way, but you can't do this unless you freeze them, and you shouldn't freeze them unless you cut them.
But you can buy that stuff already like that.
Not Snickers, you can.
Yes, you can. I do it every day.
Okay, every day?
Yes,
well,
sir.
Well, go get me some.
Anyway. Call U.S. Foods.
Okay.
10-pound box.
Okay. There you go. You heard it.
All broke up. We keep them in the fridge.
Okay, so we'll plug it in first. It's going to spin a lot faster. And we'll start it up. What we're doing is we're taking a Snickers bar and making pretty much Snickers powder. But it's a real Snickers bar, so the powder is real Snickers. It's not, you're not adding anything else to it. We will in a minute, but there's a reason for that too. And when we're done, we're not done yet, but this is what you'll get. You'll get ground up Snickers bars, and I do it as fine as I can get it. Where's that knife I lent you?
I think I left it in someone.
Here it is.
Quiet.
For a professional setting, you wouldn't use a RoboTube versus a...
A what? A RoboTube?
Like a...
No, I tried a Cuisinart, didn't work. I'm telling you, this is the only thing that works for me. But however you can get the dust, you know, I'm down on that, but this is... did I just say I'm down on that? That's your influence, I think. Gives me all these handshakes last night. Now, how do you determine that 24 bars will do it? That's a horse of a different color. That's a tale for another day. But you'll create your recipes and you'll see what you need. I know that in my full batch, 48 bars works good. I try to make my recipes fit. For instance, this is how the mix comes in these bladders. Universally, and it's 10 quarts per bladder. So I try to make my recipes 10 quarts. And the Snickers bars, coincidentally, come 48 bars to a commercial box. So that's the recipe.
What makes do you use classic?
Well, you mean what percent butter fat?
I'm talking about like bladder, like what grain do you buy?
Well, hold off on that for a minute, all right? We'll get into it. In my store, I like all the ice creams to be bold. I like the flavor to really come out, so that you know right away what you're eating. So in addition to this, I always add a little something to boost the flavor. Now, what would boost the flavor of a Snickers bar?
Peanut butter.
Well, not peanut butter, but peanuts, right? And what else? Caramel, right? So what I do, that's it for the work in this. Oh, you saw this sitting here, sure. So what I do is I add peanuts. Now, in a full batch, I would add, no, peanuts. What did he say? What did he say? In a full batch, I would add a quart of peanuts. In a half batch, half a quart. And also a little caramel. I found a great product at Restaurant Depot. In the store, I use Lion's Caramel. It comes in the big cans. It's pretty good stuff. But I found this, which is Lion's Sea Salt Caramel. So you can't beat that. So I bought it, and gosh, it works pretty good. I just said gosh, didn't I? Jeez. Gosh. And a little of this high-priced vanilla here. My formulas call for, especially because it's free here, 1 ounce of vanilla to 1 ounce of mix, which is unusual, but I got to tell you, it works. To 1 quart, I'm sorry. An ounce to a quart. Don't write down an ounce to, what did I say, an ounce? An ounce to an ounce, that's, hell, this stuff? $1,000 batch. So that's pretty good. So there you have it. That's it. Now, if you think about what we're putting in there, we're going to put in the ice cream mix.
Now, is that mix just a creme anglaise?
What?
That's your basic ice cream-based creme anglaise.
Creme anglaise? What is? I don't understand that.
I'm sorry.
No, that's all right.
I'm used to the terminology.
Creme anglaise.
Is it just your egg, sugar, vanilla, and milk that's already been?
That's basically what that is.
This is pre-made. To make your own is an exercise in futility, because I don't have the box for this. But the box for this lists 35 ingredients. It's basically heavy cream, skim milk, milk solids, and a little sugar. But if you make it yourself, then you've got to pasteurize it. And the pasteurizer is $6,000 or more. And it's so easy to get these. And they're great. And you can get these in percentage of butterfat. You can get 8%, 10, 12, 14, or 16, depending on what you like.
All dairies are guaranteed to do that?
Guaranteed? There is no law. But you find a dairy, they'll make this. Not guaranteed. No guarantees in life.
What do you recommend, like 12%?
Well, I use 10%. I find, and I think this is 10.
Probably 14.
What?
Probably 14.
Why would you say that?
Because the advertising probably does it 14 or 15.
No. Anyhow, so how much of this do we need?
The whole thing.
The whole thing?
Half.
So how many quarts would we need? 5 quarts. Okay. So we need something that'll measure 5 quarts. Why, this'll measure 5 quarts, or thereabouts. If you've never handled these, it's an experience. I, of course, am an expert at it.
Wear an apron.
An apron, that's not going to cut it. If this goes, your apron won't even sop it up off the floor. So we'll go between 4 and 6 quarts. We'll store that over there. Okay, I like to get all the ingredients prepared in one spot, because when you're making ice cream, distractions will cost you a batch of ice cream. If you forget something and then it's done and you taste it, something's wrong, and you just throw it away. I throw it away. Throwing away a lot of ice cream. So I've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 ingredients, and on my card, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 ingredients. I know I'm okay.
Vanilla.
Snickers, peanuts, caramel, vanilla mix. So we'll throw this in there. Now understand, you can make this, you can make any candy bar. One of my favorites growing up was Payday. And that's my next project, which I'll start Friday. I'll work on getting Payday into ice cream and making Payday ice cream.
Have you done it before?
Haven't done Payday before. Right now at the store, we have not all at the same time because we rotate all our flavors, but I have M&M, I have Reese's, Snickers, Heath Bar, ooh, good one, Heath Bar Crunch. I can't remember, but I like the candy ice creams, and people love them, because what I do on my menu board, I try to use the logo of the ice cream, because when you buy these bars, they come in the big box, and you just simply cut the logo off and put that up, and it's so recognizable. Everyone in the world knows what that is, all of these, actually. Also, I came up with... everyone was talking about Kit Kats, so I combined two flavors, and now we sell Coffee Cat. which is a coffee chip with a Kit Kat in it, ground up, frozen, ground up, same thing. And whew, that's good stuff.
Almond Joy is really good too.
Almond Joy, interesting. I won an award for my coconut ice cream many years ago when I first started. Totally Coconut, I called it. And after, I don't know, 3-4 years, I decided to make Mounds Bar. So what I did was I used my coconut. Obviously, Mounds Bar is coconut and dark chocolate. So I got dark chocolate in a syrupy type base. It's actually, I'll tell you, it's Hershey's Special Dark, it's called. It's a fantastic product. And what I did was, as the coconut was coming out, I put it into a big container. On one of these videos, if you look back, you'll see how to make the swirls in the ice cream. So I took my coconut, a variegate, you know, the nice little, so that every scoop is swirled. You know, it has the coconut and the chocolate swirled into it, and we call that Mounds Bar. If you do it with for Almond Joy, then instead of Hershey Special Dark, I would use milk chocolate, because that's what Almond Joy is, and I would maybe add some slivered almonds to it. And then you have that. And it's certainly easy to do. You take your coconut, make your coconut ice cream, and then throw your almonds in, your slivered almonds, right in the machine. And when it comes out, you swirl it with the milk chocolate. And then you have a great Almond Joy bar. I got to tell you, the thing about this business, what we taught Monday morning, first thing, was the reasons to get into this business. And of course, there are three of them. And the first one is profit. They're incredible profit in this business. But the second one was art. You get to be creative. You get to play house. You know, you get to come up with flavors and play. And I love that part. And the third part, what was the third part? This is fun. I mean, I'd rather be in my store than anywhere else. I love that place.
When you just gave the example going from Mound to Almond Joy, how you would change it to...
From coconut to Almond Joy, right.
And then you'd add almond.
Right.
Do you look at the protein, or like protein's going to cost more to add in? So that being said, do you look at your food cost variable?
One of the... I'm sorry, I'm taking too long, aren't I? I'm sorry. They're so interesting, these people.
I get it.
God, I'm on the clock. Oh, man. All right.
Boss.
Okay. I can't multitask. I have to concentrate. All right. Give me a minute. You'll see what we're adding. You know what we have, right? We're going to add it. Oh, God. So look, my Band-Aid won't do this.
No, it won't.
I like to add the mix first, the ice cream mix, then ingredients. So we have a saying, right? Mix, add. What do we do? Mix, turn on, add ingredients, right? Do you have a, where are you running? You have a scoop?
No,
you don't have a scoop, do you?
We have a bar back there.
A scoop?
I don't.
No?
Maybe I might have one, hold on.
I can't do this that way, Ken.
You tell me.
All right, I'm sorry. I have to. It's going to go all over the floor. I'm right-handed.
No, that's okay. As long as we do discharge it.
As long as what?
As long as we discharge it with you out of the way.
Oh, okay.
That's all I got.
This will take a week.
I know. Here, put in another container and squeeze it like you did in your
Arrogant. Yeah.
You want a container?
You have a squeezable one?
Yeah.
Make a coffee cup.
Use a coffee cup. Okay.
That's good.
You missed that. Use a squeeze cup.
Oh, yeah, this works real good, Steve.
Want me to do it for you, Jeff? I saw the video. I'm not the one who opened the door to see how the was going.
Yeah, by the way, you know why that happened, right?
No, why?
You tell me.
Yeah, because you opened the door to see how I was doing.
Well, but I always do that. So why did it happen here?
Because it's twice the size and takes a little longer
and
to
the
freeze.
Speed, right, and all that stuff.
That's right.
Correct. Correct. I like to add everything once that happens. How do we get that out? There's no extra charge for each one of these tips. They come with today's class. You're free to write them down.
Yes, I meant to.
Peanuts and caramel. This is the what?
Salted or unsalted?
Salted or unsalted peanuts.
Peanuts? You determine that.
You gonna put that whole container in there?
I am. I am. In a full batch, which is what I make, I use two of those, or that amount. So there you have. You've never tasted Snickers ice cream like this. You know, most places you go for Snickers ice cream, it's vanilla ice cream with pieces of Snickers in it. That just doesn't cut it. This will be Snickers ice cream like you can't believe. Have you gone to the supermarket and bought those Snickers ice cream bars? Of course you have, but they taste good, right? This is the real deal here. You saw what we added. We added Snickers and the Snickers type ingredients. Yes, sir.
How big are the bars?
How big are the bars?
Yeah, they come in different sizes. Okay.
That's how big they are. I want that back. So this bar is how big?
1.86 ounces.
So what would you do to make this recipe? Come on. Come on, man. You multiply 1.8 times 24, divide it by 16, you get your pounds and your ounces, and then you can buy any size Snickers bar, right?
Or buy a big box.
Or whatever. They don't come in a big box.
They do.
No, they don't.
I'm telling you, they do.
What do you do for a living?
I make ice cream.
Well, I make ice cream.
And the point?
The point is that the Snickers don't come in a big bulk box.
It comes in a 10-pound box.
Broken, not broken up.
Give me your phone thing, you didn't get access.
Let me take a quick poll here. Who are you going to believe? Does anybody want to see this?
I do.
I do. Where are you from? North Carolina?
Alabama.
Alabama. Or as they say, I can't say that. But you know what I was going to say, right? At lunch, we'll talk about it.
I'm ignoring.
Okay, so what are we going to do now? Turn on the refrigeration, right. Now, according to Steve, this is taking way too long, but I would rather cut out a flavor and have you learn how to do this on any candy bar. Any candy bar. I mean, I'm doing it with Payday, which I never thought was possible. But Payday. Now this is 3.4 ounces. Almost double what that one was, right? So I would start with the same amount. Now what would we added caramel and peanuts to the Snickers. What would we add to this? Peanuts and caramel. Whoa! Because this bar, I don't know if you're a fan of these things, but what it is peanuts, a very thin caramel to adhere the peanuts to the center nougat. Nougat. Strange word, isn't it? Nougat. So, That's what I would add. Now, to the M&Ms, which we make all the time in the store, it's a big seller, I add mini chips.
So you make that, the powder, and then you add the mini chips, not powder.
Correct.
Is that right?
Correct.
Do you have to set the timer off when you're making ice cream as well, or is it cut off?
You don't need a timer.
You just kind of know when it's ready.
You'll know. I'll let you know when it's ready.
What temperature is it coming out at for ice cream?
I don't know. I don't care.
Well, I mean, because Italian ice is pretty servable.
I have no idea. Let me tell you something. I'm glad you brought that up. Let me tell you about this business. This business is full of myths and crap. And it's true. There's a lot of people want to stand in your way from making a good living. And they do it by throwing equipment at you that you may not need, ideas at you that you may not need, temperatures, all this math that you don't need. This is a very simple business. Incredibly simple. Steve will tell you that. These machines are made like tanks. You can't hurt them. All you do is, I mean, think about it. You want to make ice cream? You put the stuff in there, it comes out, and you sell it. It's very simple. What temperature do you want it at? After it comes out, you put it in the freezer. If it's too hard, you turn the freezer up a little. If it's too soft, you turn the freezer down a little. True, the health department wants temperature thermometers in the freezer, but they're irrelevant. I have 13 freezers. And each one has a thermometer, I guess. I never look at them. As a matter of fact, they're iced over. I can't even read them. They're in there, and he was happy that they were there yesterday, but it doesn't matter, because your vanilla is going to be rock hard at -8 degrees, but your tiramisu won't be hard at 10 degrees. So to have strict, rigid formulas for what it should be is irrelevant. And your store could be in Tacoma. My store's in Florida. Totally different. My store is warmer than yours, and I'm seasonal. I'm not as seasonal as you are. And the first batch of the day is going to freeze differently than the last batch of the day. But none of this means anything. All that means anything is when this comes out, it tastes good, people are going to buy it. It's so simple. So keep your equipment simple, keep your ideas simple, take the math and throw it out the window. I don't know if I'm stepping on toes here, but...
You're doing absolutely right.
Okay, just keep this business simple, and you're going to make a ton of money. The first thing I told everyone in the class this Monday, the very first thing is, on this planet, there are 7 billion people. There are 2-month-old babies. There are 120-year-old people. There's people in Nigeria, people in Alaska, people in Oahu. Every single person on this planet wants this. No matter how old they are or what part of the world they come from, you put a bowl of ice cream in front of those people, they want it. So your customer base is 7 billion people. I don't care if you open up in Timbuktu or in Manhattan, you're going to have customers. Everybody who walks by your store, everybody who knows you have an ice cream store, wants what you're selling them. It's not like shoes, it's not like computer parts, it's not like anything else in the world. There's nothing else that is so desired by every single person on this planet. You can't miss. This business is yours to screw up. That's it, done preaching.
If you go to any other class or watch any other videos, and Jeff and I are up to 250 videos on YouTube, you go to any of them, and they'll be wearing a white suit and a hat, you know, or a chef's outfit and stuff like that. They're using something, I don't know what it's called, a spectrograph or something to see the specific gravity of the sugar. And they're heating this and mixing that, and they're talking about infusing the flavor. You put it in the machine, you take it out, and it's delicious. Jeff, I get a call at least once a week, and I used to be offended by it. Now I'm very proud of it. The person on the other end says, Steve, I watch your videos, and I think to myself, if that idiot Steve Thompson can do this, imagine what I could do. Well, it is that simple, and I am an idiot.
And that's what I thought sitting there.
But I know how to build a great machine, and he knows how to make great ice cream. Can't be simpler than that.
It's simple, so simple. And, you know, I started my business when I was 60. if I had known, if I had come to this class in 1972, right out of college, there's no limit to what I would have done. Now, I'm in a position where I make enough money, but I could open I could open more stores if I didn't want to do it myself. If you want to join me, we'll talk. But it's so lucrative, and it's so simple. It just, you can't miss. Everybody wants what you have. Can you think of anything else like that? There is nothing else.
Jeff used to be a liberal until he started making money and paying taxes. Now he's an arch conservative. But, you know, ask yourself, if you're from Southern California, you know, sorry to offend you. But if you tell me you want to go into making ice cream to make the world a better place and all that, the reason you go into this business or any business is to make money and to improve your level of life. Now, every time I sell a machine, I know, how many people work for you, Jeff, part-time and full-time?
Eight.
Every time I sell a machine, I am putting into business between 8 and 11 people somewhere in the world. Now, I'm pretty happy with that. I'm also happy with the money I'm making from selling machines. So you go into business for your personal enjoyment and at the end of the day to say I was
profit,
successful.
Profit, art, and fun.
Yeah.
If you're missing one of those, don't do it. If you're not going to have fun, then don't do it because then it's work.
Right.
If you're not going to make money, don't do it because it's futile. And if you're not going to be artistic, then get somebody in there who will be, because this is I have 40 flavors. I wish I could have 140. That's how much I like making ice cream and coming up with different things. And it's easy. It's whatever you like, whatever you think will work. I've had flops, so you throw them away. But for every flop, I've got 20 great flavors. Okay, we ready? What do you say?
You're increasing your business by word of mouth.
Yeah, I do no advertising.
More like taste
and
about.
We're in the middle of nowhere. And I'm only open 4 hours a night, six nights a week. And I get 200 people a night. So,
okay. As they say, go figure.
Can you
turn the other way, please, for the camera?
Okay, how do we know it's ready? Somebody asked how we know it's ready. No timer. I know it's ready when it holds a peak, when... There's two ways that I can tell it's ready. When I look at it up here, I see that the gloss isn't on there anymore. The mix is glossy, but when it's ready, it becomes matte or dull. And then the other way is when it holds a peak. When you let it out and it doesn't smooth right into the whatever else is in there. When it holds a peak, I know I'm ready, so I'm ready. You ready?
I'm ready.
This. You didn't prepare anything.
Oh, you didn't tell me to. I was so in awe of listening to you. Thanks. What do you want me to do?
I don't know. I just want to be able to scoop it. I didn't call you stupid. I said I want to be able to scoop it. Bowls and spoons. That's it.
Okay.
Scoops.
We're good.
Okay, we're good.
Do we have scoops?
Just throw these somewhere. Mm-hmm. I know where those are going.
Yeah, right in the freezer.
Okay, so this is Snickers ice cream. Another thing we'll get into in a minute. You see the color of this? It's beige. Most of the ice creams you're going to make, homemade ice creams, they're beige. They're not very pretty to look at because we're not adding red dye 32, we're not adding chocolate color, they're just beige. Which means that, don't get me started. Why don't you taste it?
Isn't that beautiful? That's a nice, simple, easy-to-make product. I will.
Very simple to make. Let's see if it's any good.
It's always good.
What happens if you...
Leave it in too long.
Yeah.
I knew somebody would ask that.
Chevy Suburban pulls up in front of your business and we take you away.
You turn off the freezer and just let it keep mixing a little bit?
God, that is Snickers bars up the wazoo. What's the question? If you let it go too long? Interesting.
Too long.
Steve, we pulled it now. We pulled the ice cream.
Yeah.
Steve pulls his later. I pull mine sooner. It's just preference. your store, you'll do what you want. I feel that when it's in there too long and you pull it, I feel it tends to become a little gummy. Marginally different, but different enough for me to say that's a little too gummy. Too, what's the word?
Tacky.
Too what?
Tacky.
Tacky? That's my presentation. if I pull it sooner, not too soon. You don't want soup out there, but this is perfect for me.
If you get it, if you pull it too soon and it's too soupy, can you dump it back in there?
No,
you won't
don't
be
pull
able
it.
To.
Don't pull it.
Yeah, that's
if
why
it's
you
too
saw
soupy,
me keep
don't
doing
take it
this.
Out.
You saw me keep checking
yeah,
it
yeah.
till it's what I want.
Okay. Now, again, pushing this, there is no timer.
You can have some here.
I could put a timer on if you want.
No, a timer's wrong because different
timer
flavors
is,
take different times.
Exactly. Every flavor is a different timing by maybe a minute.
They're storming
or two.
The Bastille.
I'll just take that one.
You may not like it. Chef, right? You may not like it.
Now, I made up an invention back in the 70s.
I haven't made an ice cream, I don't know.
Where I took an amp meter and put it on a machine, and you could read the amp meter and say, okay, that ice cream's ready. A certain Italian company, I won't mention, Cappagiani, stole the idea and called it the Heart-O-Matic, which is now called the Heart-O-Tronic.
That's what people kill for.
And,
they want to get right up to that.
It's an interesting concept, but theirs turns off the machine, and it turns it off every time the vanilla's ready. So here we are adding all this extra sugar with the candy. And so that's going
to
increase the freezing time.
To prevent
so
you
do it.
Money
when
business,
I watch Paula bake a cake, she doesn't. She sets the timer for 24 minutes. She doesn't pull it at 24 minutes. She goes and gets a fork and tests it to see how it is. So it's a simple experimenting that you'll get very good at.
What butter pan is this?
Only 10.
Margin. Yeah.
It depends on what's in your town.
We were thinking of going with
Classic Mix. Classic Mix is probably the best in the country. Classic Mix Partners, great, great stuff. And the nicest people on earth. Yeah.
Girl.